exemplary of his faith, which delivered one from fear, and dedicate the hope of myself to you on this day. This is the stage of Atma Nivedan, that floating in the ocean of material existence, maybe by the mercy of our spiritual master and Krishna, that our soul will become awakened to realize the situations, that without the shelter of the Supreme Personality Godhead, we will be miserable. And that when it will come as a sincere urge in our heart, we realize, we try everything, nothing works, because our mentality is like that, that still we have the ego that I can do, I can do, I can do. But in Bhagavatam there is a very nice verse, that Atma Jaya Sutta Shivir Edaman Madhavatuna Naya Evadati Abhidhatam Vah Tvam Akinchana Gochana. Unless and until one really materially exhausted, the sincere feeling to render the devotional service to the lotus feet of Supreme Lord never arose in our heart. Because as long as we are situated well in our material life, we don't want to remember it. Unless we have a perfectly good activity, then we will know that we should be become grateful to the Lord that who has given us this body. He has given us so many things. At least let me do something as a reciprocation. Like, you know, father and mother, they work, they have a children. And father and mother will give them some quarters, whatever change left, so they have their piggy banks. And maybe children, when they open it, they say, hey, my dad's birthday is coming up, let me use my piggy bank. So hardly he found $12, $15, whatever, maybe he bought a beautiful car, one rose or something with that money. And the children will give to the father. How father will feel so pleased, isn't it? He did another one. It was father's money anyway. But when he gave back to the fathers, father feel very happy. So similarly, whatever we have in our possessions doesn't belong to us. And even if it comes, we shouldn't become owner of those things. In our scripture, it clearly mentions that everybody has certain amount that they should live on. Extra, whatever comes in our way, we should utilize in the service where it belongs. We know that Supreme Lord owns those things. It's not that the money comes so you can spend lavishly whatever you want to do. You are not the owner. We should use our quota, whatever it is, to maintain our soul and body together. Rest of it, we should leave it for the service of God. This is what our Acharya has mentioned. And it takes some time. Like I said, you know, it's so painful to see that when we are in a very good situation, right? And suppose somebody approach for anything, some, okay, you donate for flowers, and you say no. And it happened by chance that you lose everything. And then you will think that even the guy was asking simple thing, I didn't do that. So in our life also, as we will progress, as our body will become weaker and weaker, we will realize so many things, but time may be too late at that time. Like that Mahavishnu Maharaj used to give the simulations that how natural death occurs. That first our dull senses will become useless. Like you won't be able to, you want to raise your hand to say somebody hello who comes to visit you. You won't be able to lift your hand. Then maybe you will be able to converse a little bit. But time will come that you won't be able to converse. Your eyes, you will be able to see person who visit you up to certain time. Time will come that you won't be able to see, your eyes will go. still the hearing will be there. So if your relatives or friends are saying something to you, you may want to respond them, but you have no, you know, you cannot speak anything at that time. And then slowly, you won't be able to hear anything. And then it will be like a complete peace and God. You can't move, you can't hear, you cannot talk, nothing. At that time, the video will start in front of our eyes, in our mind. The Lord is sitting as a super soul in our heart. He is witnessing each and every activity. We think that, you know, nobody is there and I can steal somebody, nobody watching, but that's not true. Always super soul is witnessing each and every activity. And that it says that Chandragupta is secretary witnessing all our activities. So he will say, all these things that we have done in our life will pass through. And at that time, you know, we feel so sorry for something that we did, which, because now we realize that why did I do it? Because now we realize what is the use of it. We came into this material world with nothing in our hand. And the day that we are going to leave this material world, we are not going to take anything with us. We have come with nothing and we are going to go with nothing. Whatever the good deeds that we perform will help us. We will get the strength. At least we will feel satisfaction that God has given me this birth and I utilize properly. At least I was able to do something in the service of God. That has a lot of value at the time of that. You know, when we pass from one state to other states, you can never go back to the states. Every moment we pass in our life, you cannot call it back. If you have made a mistake, somebody that you may have harmed their feeling, that person may not come in front of you again in your life. And you will feel repent for it. Why did I do that? So all these consequences is there. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is giving us that time will come, hopefully that it should come sooner in our life, that we should come to the conclusions that let me surrender my whole life. And He will give us the protection. Whatever I will deserve, He will give. In our life, it's not happened like that sometimes. That we didn't work for anything, whatever we were doing, but suddenly our lives get changed. Something good happened in our life. Who does those things? Supreme Lord. He is the most valuable source that we can ever find. It says that person died, then all his relatives, everybody is there, their connection is lost. He lost the connections with the bank balance, he cannot write a check. He lost everything. So in our life, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, since they can't take little step, take the bold step in your life. This life is moving so fast as the sun rises, no time will come up, and as the sun set, the day is over, the day will never come. We feel that's a very long life, but the demigods who lives in the upper planetary systems, they want to come, take birth in the age of Kali, because we have a bone. By simply chanting the Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, we can cross over these messages once and for all. So sublime process. And Srila Prabhupada is right, he said the next 10,000 years is the golden time in Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga is 430,000 years, we have passed maybe 5,000 some years. So 430,000 24,000 something years is still remaining for age of Kali. Next 10,000 years is still, if you want to pursue the devotional practice, nobody will stop you. You can dedicate your life. But after 10,000 years, so many demonic people will appear in this world. Even though you want to go to the temple, they will harass you. They may break all the temple. Who knows? So we are so lucky that we have found, Krishna has made that very divine arrangement for all the souls now existing in the material world, that they have appeared in the golden age. That what the age of Satyuga, people has to, used to live 100,000 years, but they have to meditate for 100,000 years. And we have seen so many Rishimunis that they do meditation for 60,000 years and all that. We heard that in Srimad Bhagavatam. What the benefit they derive after meditating for 100,000 years in age of Treta Yuga by doing the performance of Yajna, which is not possible in the age of Kali, because the ingredients, the richness that you need to have, the donation that you need to give to the brahmanas, the qualified brahmanas who can perform the yajna, by recitations of the prayer, the brahmanas should ignite the fire, not by using the lighter or the matches. That power was there on the prayers. So those qualified brahmanas is not available. In Dwapara you build a very opulent temples and do opulent service of the Lord in the temple. That was the way of attaining the love of God. But in age of Kali, simply by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Whatever the Satyuga that person has to meditate in Treta Yuga to perform very good Dev Yajna, or in Dwapara Yuga to do the very opulent worship of Lord, same result you can derive by just chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. What a boon that we have. So we will meet again at 2:30, right? It's about time, or what time you have to stop?
1:00.
1:00, right? So it's about time, right? So we will get together again at 2:30, where we will discuss more about the glorification of chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And I hope everyone can come, because I think in my practical life, I have learned something, and I think it's useful that you also put in practice. It will make the devotional life very simple. As Prabhupada says, for the simple person, devotional life is very simple. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.